Currency takes the forms of many things, from shells to paper to metal. The idea of money is the trading something of value for a service or product. The history of money began with commodity money, since there was problems with barter. Commodity money were items that were represented, such as a token. The value of a token is perceived by the user, for who recognizes the value of the token, who recognizes the value of the good. Having a token, for example, for a specific weight of wheat, must be same economically as having the wheat at hand. This is what gives the commodity money its value. In ancient Africa and China, people used cowrie shells as commodity for purchasing things such as food, clothes, and other services. Even up until today, some indigenous tribes still use cowrie shells as currency. In Mesopotamia, circa 3000 BC, a shekel was used as a unit of barley. In feudal Japan, the trade system was based on koku, a unit of rice per year. When they ran out of a certain kind of money, they would adopt foreign currencies. But throughout history, gold has been accepted in many cases.
From early times, metals were available have usually been favored for use as proto-money over such commodities as cattle, bullet shells, or salt, because they are at once durable, portable, and easily divisible. The first known ruler who officially set standards of weight and money was Phi Don. It is an electrum starter for a turtle coin, coined at Argina Island. This remarkable coin dates about 700 BC. Electrum coins were also introduced about 650 BC in Leiter. Coinage was widely adopted across Ionia and mainland Greece during the 6th century BC. The discovery of the touchstone led the way for metal-based commodity money and coinage. Any soft metal could be tested for purity on a touchstone, allowing one to quickly calculate the total amount of a particular metal in a lump. Monetary gold spread very quickly from Asia Minor, where it was first gained wide usage, to the entire world. Using this system required several steps and mathematical calculation. The touchstone allowed a person to estimate the amount of gold in an alloy. To make this process easier, coins were pre-weighted and pre-alloyed, so as long as the manufacturer was aware of the origin of the coin, there was no need of the touchstone. Coins were typically created by governments in a careful process, and then stamped with an emblem that guaranteed the weight and the value of the metal. Metal-based coins had the advantage of carrying the value within the coins themselves. On the other hand, they caused problems. A problem was the simultaneous coexistence of gold, silver, and copper coins in Europe. English and Spanish traders valued gold coins more than silver coins, as many of the neighbors did, with the effect that the English gold-based guinea coin began to rise against the English silver-based crown in 1670s and 1680s. Consequently, silver was ultimately poured out of England for dubious amounts of gold coming into the country at a rate no other European nation would share. In China, the use of paper money was closely related to the shortage of metal for coins. In ancient China, coins were circular with a rectangular hole in the middle and were tied together with ropes, where if a person became rich, they would become quite heavy, so the person would leave the money with a trustworthy courier and have a note saying that he could regain his money with this note. Promissory notes. The world's first banknotes came to be around the 600s during the Song Dynasty and were ended in 1455 to end inflation and economic expansion. In Europe, banknotes were issued in 1660s, but when the bank ran out of coins, also known as becoming bankrupt, it simply ceased the issuing of banknotes in 1664. In the early 1690s, the Massachusetts Bay Colony were the first of the 13 colonies to issue banknotes. By the early 1700s, all of the colonies had their own card colonial script. After a line of failing banks in America in in 1933 at a public acceptance of replacing precious metals with banknotes by the Executive Order 6102. These clay tablets from ancient Mesopotamia, the present-day Baghdad, specify that a debtor will repay a lender 330 measures of grain. Second tablet says that the debt of 4 measures of barley should be paid back to the bearer of the tablet. These dates back 4,000 years. The idea of paying back to the bearer leads us to believe that banknotes are simply promise to pay. On most money you see today have a phase of promising an amount. For example, the $20 British pound was previously a promise for 20 pounds of silver. Banknotes are mainly made of cotton paper weighing at 80 to 90 grams per square meter. In Japan and China, banknotes were made with mulberry bark and watermarks were added to prevent counterfeiting. Watermarks were made by making the paper thinner, making it able to be seen in the light. Banknotes were later backed by the nation's reserves of gold and silver instead of the coins. The banknote previously promised the British pound was the closest equivalent in amount of gold, and with the outbreak of World War I, they abandoned the gold standard. The gold standard is the backing of banknotes with gold. They tried bringing back, but during the 1920s, it was the end during the Great Depression. States used gold and silver certificates as representative money. Now we use fiat money, which is money that is not backed by anything but a value given by the government. In 1971, US definitely switched that fiat money. The innovation of paper money or banknotes has affected our society by reducing the amount of coins a person has to have on hand. It also created a trust between citizens and the government. The promise that the piece of paper in your pockets have the value it displays. This new form of currency, paper, reduced the complications of having to weigh coins and as fiat money. Came along, it also ended weighing of coins to make sure that the amount of precious metal was equivalent to the standard. That is one downfall to the production of paper money, which is dealing with counterfeiting. But most countries have anti-counterfeiting mechanisms, such as carving portraits so delicately, some paper money having 11 lines per millimeter. In the portraits of president, this universal innovation has changed the way the world purchases products and services. Money is what makes the world go round. Now it's in the form of paper.